Hello, this is Mario from ODEON. In this video, we would like to give you some tips on exporting nice, clear figures for your reports. Here, we will use the example of exporting a grid response. A common issue when exporting figures is text becoming so small that it is hard to read. This happens when a figure is quite large, because when placed into the document, it has to be shrunk to fit, also shrinking the text. To avoid this, it is actually better to reduce the size of the figure before exporting it. Then, the text will be larger relative to the rest of the figure. You can set a default figure size by going to Options, Program Setup, Graphics Exchange. You can also access this tab directly by clicking on this icon. In the Graphics Exchange settings, you can click on this checkmark to use this size for figures by default. And of course, you can change these values, although the current ones should work well. Here, you can select whether exported files will be generated as a graphics file, or if it will be copied to the Windows clipboard. If you select Graphics File, ODEON will prompt you to select a folder and a file name when you use the Ctrl-C shortcut. Otherwise, you will just need to use the paste command in your document. You can also select the default file format. We would recommend using a vector format, such as enhanced metafiles, whenever you are able to. The advantage of vector formats over formats like bitmap, JPEG, and PNG is that a vector image does not lose quality when you enlarge it. If you need another vector format, like SVG or EPS, for example for use in LaTeX, you can export the figure from ODEON in EMF format, then use the free software Inkscape to save it in another vector format. Now, let's see how we can adjust the presentation of the image. Remember that you can rotate the model by holding left click, drag it by holding right click, and zoom with the scroll wheel. To zoom in and out with smaller increments, you can toggle small steps with the S key. Remember that you can find all the functions and shortcuts available for the current window and tab in the context-sensitive menu up here. If you would like to save this view, you can add it to the list of default views with the Insert key. Then, you will eventually find it when you cycle through the default views with the spacebar. There are several ways in which you can make the results easier to see. One way is to have the grid response drawn on top of the geometry with the D key. This gives you a very clear view of the grid response. If you want to get only some of the lines out of the way, you can toggle exterior and interior surfaces with the T key, which will cycle between showing either interior surfaces, exterior surfaces, none, and both. Or you can use the Ctrl-L shortcut to disable some layers. You might also want to hide the coordinate system, which you can do with the X key. And you can also toggle the active sources with Shift S. Rulers will automatically display when the perspective projection is turned off. If you want these rulers in your figures, you can turn off the perspective projection with the P shortcut. Or, you can use one of the default views that have perspective off by default. and you can change the length units in Options, Program Setup, Other Settings. Then, just refresh the 3D view. The new unit will now appear by default for all new figures. Just remember that this will also affect dimension units in other places in the software. For example, when defining positions of sources and receivers. The value range for grid responses is automatic by default, but you can set a manual range which could get you a more informative figure. To do this, you go to the room acoustic parameter list, then expand tables, and then find your acoustic parameter. Make sure to enable manual grids, then enter the minimum and maximum values here. In this window, you can also change the color scale. A blank option simply means that it will use the default color scale specified in the program setup. Keep in mind that the number of colors will influence the spacing between the numbers on the scale, even if there are interpolated colors in between. When ready, you can use the Ctrl-C shortcut to save the figure, which you can then insert into your report. With that, we conclude this tutorial and we hope you have found it useful. Good luck!